everyone, welcome to my channel. Today, yes, we are going to be listening to Lover.
I'm so excited!
It's the last Taylor Swift album for me to listen to because I've listened to all the others. Once I listen to this, it'll be it. I have listened to a few songs because my friend's obsessed with Lover, the album. And she asked me to listen to a few songs. So I have listened to Cruel Summer, I Think He Knows, Miss Americana and the Heartbreak Prince, Paper Rings, London Boy, and It's Nice to Have a Friend, which is kind of a lot now that I look at it. But like, let's just listen to the album, okay? I haven't listened to all of it. You can skip those ones if you want to, but please don't. Listen and vibe with me.
I'm really, really excited. I can't really believe it's happening.
Until all of my sunshine was gone, gone, gone. And I couldn't get away from you. Hit my feelings more than Drake, so yeah. Your name on my lips, tongue tied. Free rent living in my mind.
Hey.
Then something happened one magical night. I forgot that you existed. Where's Taylor? I thought it would kill me, but it didn't. Oh no. Is so fun and mature, but fun and mature at the same time. Because she's Taylor. I forgot you existed. And what a diss. Like, you were living rent-free in my mind, but now I forgot you freaking existed.
I forgot that you existed. It isn't love, it isn't hate, it's just indifference.
That's a great line. That's a great line. Taylor, I feel like love has made you more mature. Because that's a freaking good line. It's not love, it's not hate, it's indifference. Which honestly, I feel like the opposite of love is indifference. Because even when you hate, it's a strong emotion to have. You know, they're two sides of the same coin. But indifference? I don't give an F.
Okay, no, and that's the thing. I don't want to carry this on because it's boring me to death now. But
oh. Never liked front row. Such a good diss.
Some hard lessons. I just forget what they were. It's all just a blur.
Everything you're saying is going in one ear and out the other.
Like, I'm not saying Justin Bieber to sing this song. I mean, like, she could sing this to Justin Bieber because I feel like they were kind of friends before. And then obviously afterwards she was not. He did some bad stuff. No, I love that ending. Difference. Doesn't Cruel Summer belong on Cruel Intentions? Like, it just gives me Ryan Felipe and, of course, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Michelle Geller, Sarah Michelle Geller. So, yeah, that's what Cruel Summer gives me. I love the song. This is such a good song. This should have been a single. This is so Cruel Intentions.
Let's just say he's very good with his hands.
I love this song. What does this mean, though? Paint your head low in the glow of the vending machine. Like, it's such a good imagery. But what does it mean? I want a tattoo of this guy. I just want a tattoo that says Cruel Summer. I like that idea. Comment down below
Taylor Swift tattoos. I love this because, like, the bar, the dive bar, Joe.
Don't do it. But is this about Joe or is it about Karlie Kloss? I don't know. Like, I think she's with Joe, but, like, you know, I won't deny people. They say that she's with Carly, like, she had a thing with Carly. I personally, I don't know. because I really believe in her job. And two of them can both exist in tandem. She could have liked Carly and Joe at the same time. That's why it's a cool summer. But
I'm being politically correct.
Because this part looks like... But that sounds like Carly. No. But I think she just drew inspiration from stuff happening in her life. That's what I think. All I can think of is Reese Witherspoon and Ryan Felipe in their car. In their car?
It's okay, you can laugh.
She's really getting you, isn't she?
I'm completely infatuated with her.
Why didn't you make that a single? How could you not make that a single? What was she doing with this album? Why wasn't that a single? It makes no sense. Who listened to this album and said, yeah, that's not a single?
So do you think I deserve better than that?
Yes.
Okay. I'm nervous. Like, I feel like it's one of those songs, if I don't like, people will hate me. Okay. I'm leaving until Feb. Oh, okay. This is beautiful. I don't know why I'm surprised. It's so sick.
Everything, you mean entire world. I'll love you until the day I die.
I usually don't like picture perfect love songs. This is good. Like, not you are in love level, but this is good. A woman knows how to be so relatable. Because let's face it, you have three living rooms, okay? You have a mansion and three living rooms, but she's making it sound like they're in like a tiny flat somewhere with a little Christmas tree.
Why, my bother you?
Oh, no.
They're covered in Swarovski crystals, girl.
Oh, my name
is Tamar Braxton, and I am a jealous woman, very proud of it.
Don't play that.
Very catchy. How do I know these lyrics already? I take this magnetic force of a man to be mine. I take this magnetic force.
Do you promise to give her fanny flutters for the rest of her life? I do.
See, this, not to bring conspiracy theories into this again, but this is why I think Taylor Swift definitely is into Joe, because I think like that's how I would describe a man if I was in love as well. I understand it sounds sapphic, but sometimes some men do have like a magnetic force. I love this. Is what I liked about Taylor. Like, she knows. I feel like we don't have songs which show men in like a beautiful light. And I know people will be like, oh, well, that's sapphic, but no, like, what's wrong in seeing a beauty in a man? Like,
life chemical inside of us that happens when we meet a person of the opposite sex.
But explain how long they say the romantic love lasts
that
and all of that.
That chemical reaction happens between those two people most of the time for only two years.
I want to know, how do people survive without Taylor Swift? Like, how do you not want to experience her? Like, how dull is your life without her? I can't understand, like, how are you functioning without Taylor Swift's songs in your life.
See, I wish everyone could experience it in this world because it feels incredible.
Why? Like, actually, why do people obsess about this woman's boyfriends and like how men she's had? Who cares?
Your typical selfish, backstabbing, slut-faced hoe bag, but it would make me more of a boss to you. I'd be a fearless
leader. I'd be an alpha type. Ooh, yeah.
Guys are fuckers.
You are something even better. You're the woman. Like, you are an exceptional woman. Oh.
Hey. He's a douche lord and I hit him.
Like, I'm listening to it and I'm like, I like it, it's beautiful, but I also don't want to listen to it because I'm feeling really sad for myself and for women in general. Never date a man who doesn't like Taylor Swift. You don't have to listen to all her songs or anything, but if you say you actively don't like her, if you cannot admit that she is a lyrical genius, then
90% of the time,
your version of 90 anyways is just unacceptable.
Come on, she's a Hunger Games fan. I don't even have to listen to it tonight. Oh my god, it's track 5, wait, I need some food, because I feel like I need some comfort food for this. Wait, right there.
Don't do it.
Oh, I like this. She's linking all her songs because it was linked to the man. Singer, or actually, I do want combat now. And cruelty, cruel summer. Like, she knows what we're gonna think. Huh? Shut up! What?
I beg your pardon? Shut up!
Why are you doing this? How can you write a song called The Archer? No, shut up! Wait.
Shut up!
Okay. Talking about cruelty, you ready for combat? I've got 100 thrown out speeches I almost said to you. Who says speeches, Peter? And then you jump from the train? Why are you on a train? Taylor, when have you last ridden a train? You're Taylor. You don't ride trains, okay?
Dude, I've never been like this mind-boggled in my entire life.
This is about Katniss. This is Katniss' perspective. You can say whatever you want.
Why didn't you just write Katniss a song on this? Who could ever leave me, darling?
But who could stay? I was trying to relate this song to you, but then, Taylor, you were like talking about fire and snow. Katniss is fire and President Snow, like invisible. Oh, shut up. This part though. It's true.
I swear to God, the things I would do to that man.
I've been suffering. I suffered for 19 years. It's time for me to shake my ass on a yacht.
Oh my God!
In Dubai.
It's so giddy and happy and like anticipation, you know? It's so pretty. Like, this song is pretty. Lyrical smile in the go. Lyrical smile. Eyes hand in my thigh. So where we gonna go? Oh. I whisper in the dark. I love this song. Part is like through her feelings, she's telling us how what kind of person he is. Like, he's a person who creates excitement, adventure, magic, mystery, and you feel it through the song, like the way she's singing. Like,
I love it.
I love this song. It's so good. It's just so beautiful and so pretty. Oh,
I love him.
I love him for you.
Oh my god, I like him. I think.
Wait, I like him too.
Care.
I don't care what they say about me, you know what I mean?
But it's got politics like this, like. This bridge, take it away. It's like a cheer, it's like a chant. It's like a cheerleading fight, like a chant. Some Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey in there. I love that. The transition, stalking on the internet, read all the books on your bed.
I get married!
I hate accidents except for when we went from friends to this.
Sorry, this is love
and I love that she had that personal detail about the icy pool, because apparently Joe's family dumped in there for Christmas. Back to the color that we painted your brother's wall. Honey, with that all the eggs and bites and flaws. Oh, you're the one I want. Love this. Oh, I love it. Oh,
luckiest girl in the world, and that I'm being loved in a way that I've never been loved before.
It really reminds me of Hours, like, oh, I want your dreary Mondays too, and wrap your arms around me, baby boy. Like, it's so cute. Like, it is so cute. It's like a cute overload. It feels fitting and nice, and like, she feels so free and happy, which we haven't heard in such a long time, because she's always so sad. Things, but I marry you with paper rings. Oh, my favorite line though is this line. The one coming up. I hate accidents except when we went from fence to this. Oh, oh, it's probably my favorite line of the whole album. The next one is Cornelia Street. So apparently this is Cornelia Street in USA. Never heard this song, so let's hear it. She actually did have a place in Cornelia Street, didn't she? Okay. And this bar reference. Like the Archer. Oh. Oh. Do it, because it's so controversial. But
No, I hate you.
log me back to that. I'm sorry, because I'm like so into the story, I forget that I'm reacting. Like, I forget I'm like reacting because I'm like reading this story. I'm like, oh god, tell me more. Tell me more about your problems and about this person. You know, the heartbreak you experienced
and how you're never gonna get over it. Like, I'm really into the story.
Everything you're saying is going in one ear and out the other.
What are they filming? Just inside, barefoot in the kitchen. Secret new beginnings. So dreamy. I love the little ending thing she put in there. That's a great song. Oh, that was her storytelling just excelled in that song.
I can be genuinely serious, Chef, from my heart of hearts. I am.
Did you sing bye? What's going on? Huh?
What is going on here?
Okay, so look, I've heard a lot of people on TikTok being like, what is, I didn't know where the lyrics came from. They were like, I don't get the Taylor Swift lyrics. What did she just say? I asked the traffic lights if I'm going to be okay. So I guess she's saying, I'm asking the traffic lights, like, which direction I'm supposed to go. Like, I'm supposed to stop, start, like, where am I supposed to go in this transition of life? She's asking the traffic lights because they're the ones, traffic lights are the ones which, like, give you directions and signals on where to go. So this lyric does make sense now that I've listened to it in the context. Well, why are people like confused? Since you were like young.
Call me when you want to be honest.
You're so confusing. Unless this is a meetup place for you.
I'm so tired. Take a look at my girlfriend.
Say that because you just talked about Joe and how you made paper rings with him, and now you're saying that you've got paper cuts on your hand. Why did you say that? Why did you do that?
Why? Why?
What are you doing?
The question is, what will you ever do if you get happy?
It's great to
I have listened to this before. I know this is Idris Elba. Nice. Of course I've listened to London Boy. I mean, I know where this place is.
both knew that we felt it anyway.
Yeah.
It didn't need to be exaggerated.
Be up on Bond Street. What are you doing on Bond Street? What are you doing on Bond Street?
Next question.
It's weird to think Taylor Swift would be Bond Street.
I'm an American. I don't have to understand anything. Buttons of my coat were tangled in my hair. In doctor's office lighting, I didn't tell you I was scared. That was the first time we were there. Holy orange bottles, each night I pray to you. Desperate people find faith, so now I pray to Jesus too. Soon you'll get better. Soon you'll get better.
She's fine. She's alive.
Everything's fine.
Okay.
Of course it's fine.
Why am I getting sad, Taylor? I will cry for anyone. I know to keep saying it. So sad. Oh my god, you cannot. You are
so cruel. How dare she put this next to a song called Soon You'll Get Better than False God?
I'm not in that headspace even. I was like,
sad. You can't just put a love song. So disrespectful. I need your
album, but like,
personally, that's like a violation. That's very muggy. That's like,
okay, I don't love this.
What did you just say? Come here. Come here now. What did you just say?
Even my phone doesn't like it. Stop. Like, I get it. The altar's in her hips. That was the nicest line in there. Ooh, that part was good too. But like, I don't know.
I just feel like I'm trying to be so honest and...
That's good.
Rise and shine.
Oh,
no. Depressed. I ain't trying to mess with your self-expression. Press them out. Yeah, haters. Snakes as in Scott and Scooter?
Call me when you want to be honest.
I like the life. You got to. The gay parade.
You are such an idiot.
Oh, okay. Oh, you need to calm down. You're having a phobia.
You know what? Fuck off. You can fuck off.
No, but like with Kissgate and everything which happened with Taylor, like, so I'd be like, I'm gonna sing about this. Like, I'm not just gonna sit down and wait. Like, I'm gonna sing about it. I don't. False accusation. That's kind of sexual.
I don't care who knows it, I will shout it from the rooftops, I'm in love.
What is this? Oh.
Instantly, I knew I'd seen the most beautiful girl on this entire planet.
Oh my god. This song is excruciating, but it's like an excruciating, blissful pain. I like being hurt. I like it.
Isn't that crazy?
It sounds like sweat. The beat is sweat. On Zayn Malik's album, that's what I'm thinking about him. There's some kind of unsubconscious connection being made between his song Sweat. Tell me that you're still mine. Tell me that we'll be just fine.
Even when I lose my mind, I need to say. Every time I wake up in the morning, all I want to do is put a smile on your face. Hey,
it's on me. Girl, you are deep. It just sounds so different. I feel like I unwrapped a really good gift, and it was like the last gift of the Christmas tree, and I was like, why isn't this the first gift gifted to me? Like,
I'm getting married!
Like, it's beautiful. Oh, she's out here, she's singing.
What is going on here?
Ooh, I like the choice. Lame guys. Oh, yeah. I think that's a beautiful song, but it tired me a lot. Tired because I was like, this is a lot of energy, a lot of extroversion, and I'm lazy.
I don't have the energy to get up.
Oh, I like this. I like that she's added a friendship song. Oh, this feels like, oh no, I shouldn't say. You knew, if you click this video, you knew I was gonna say it sounds like my Peter and Candace on the roof. But I like it.
Why are you so obsessed with me?
Oh, why am I like this? I have a problem. Ooh, sounds like a battle cry. I like that. I get it, rice on the flower, round, rice on the ground does look like snow, but also who was forced into a marriage or was trying to be forced into a marriage by President Snow? I'm just and her bluff was called because she was bluffing at the time.
Thank you for making that announcement that no one cared about.
We should desexualize the bed, okay? That's what should happen. Sounds a bit weird. Love it.
See, I wish everyone could experience it in this world because it feels incredible.
I love this one. Never goodbye. Not YouTube, but never goodbye. Oh. I don't wanna look at anything else now that I saw you. I don't wanna think of anything else now that I thought of you. Oh. I've been sleeping so long in a 20-year dark night. And now I see daylight. I only see daylight. This is very early for a bush like this. She said I can go from New York sneaking into your bed. I just believe love will be burning red. I heard burning red and I was like, but it's golden like daylight. Oh, let's listen.
And I believe that I'm head over heels in love with you.
Anything else now that I saw you?
I can never look away.
I don't want to think of anything else now that I thought of you.
Oh, I love this
game. It's been so long and it's been a dark night.
This golden light. You know that someone's tattoo, you know. Someone has that tattooed on their body because of Taylor Swift.
You're lucky that I'm gracing you with ideas.
This is the best album ending. Yes, I stick by that. This is the best album ending. That little voice note from her, very personal. I like this a lot. Is my favorite Taylor Swift album? No, but it's really good. Obviously, it's really good. Like, she's happy, she's content, she has a lot of funky different beats. I think the problem is it's too long. Too many songs. If we had cut down, how could I say that? How could I say that about an album from Taylor Swift?
It's diabolical.
How could I be so ungrateful?
Unbelievable. I will never forget how they did that.
But no, I mean, when you listen to it in one sitting, it's really long. But I loved it. So yeah, let me know what you think. Comments down below. See you next week. And subscribe.